Hello children, today again I came up with your class, okay? And today I am dealing with your first poem in your textbook. So all of you please open your textbook, and how I am reading, you just look into your textbook and see the lines properly, okay? So today's poem's name is To a Pair of Saurus Cranes. It is the poem of birds. Which birds? Saurus cranes. Okay? And this poem is written by Manmohan Singh. Who has written this? Manmohan Singh. Before I start the explanation, I want to tell you, okay, what are these Saurus cranes? How they will look and where they are found. I will tell you, you just listen. The Saurus cranes are the tallest of flying birds. They are found in parts of India, in subcontinents. Then where they are found? Southwest Asia and Australia. Okay, they are found in these places. It is a very beautiful poem, okay? It shows that animals also are having the feelings. Not only the human beings, but the animals also are having the feelings. Now, let us start with our explanation, okay? Now, see the first para, what it is. The male was shot as he necked to pull the reluctant sun out from the rim of horizon. See, one morning a pair of saurus, pair means what? Two birds, okay? One bird was male and one was female, okay? Pair means it is two. Two saurus cranes were flying in the sky, okay? They were very happy. They were very much joyful. They were flying very beautifully in the sky. It looked like the male bird was stretching its neck. Okay? To pull the reluctant means, what is the meaning of reluctant? Means it is unwilling. Okay? It was trying to pull the sun. It was looking like that. Okay? Reluctant sun from the horizon. What is the meaning of horizon here? The horizon means the place where the earth and the sky appears to meet. Okay? While you are going, for example, you can see in the mountains. Okay? When you go top of the mountain and if you see the far away, means you will see that the sky and the earth are meeting to each other. Yes or no? That what both are meeting, that it is joined, that place is called as the horizon. Okay? Hope you are understanding this. Okay? That is horizon. Okay? The poet is telling that it looked like the, to meet the crane looked like that. How the horizon is looking like that only, these two birds also were looking like that, the poet is telling here. As if it is pulling the unwilling sun, that is from the horizon. It was looking that as if the crane is pulling the sun, okay? It is the thinking. You don't think that really the birds are pulling. Okay? It is just a thought. Okay? Both the birds were very happy and they were happily flying in the sky. At that moment, what happened? You see here. But something happened that they never thought. They were not able to think about that. That happened. What happened here? The male bird was shot by a cruel hunter. The cold-hearted cruel hunter killed the bird. He shot the male bird and the male bird fell down. Okay? The cruel hunter, what he did? He shot the male bird. male saurus crane. Okay, see the next para. She flew crying as he was picked up hands and jaws, and a proud neck was humbled to lie like dirty linen in a chorus washing bag. Seer. When the male bird, while flying, the hunter shooted him. Yes, he shooted the male bird. At that time, what happened? That male bird fall down. It fell down. Okay, it will fall down here. And the female saurus crane, what it will do? It was very helpless. It was helpless. Why? Because when the male bird was falling down, at that time, can the female bird, can it catch that? No. So it was very much helpless. Okay? And it saw the death of its mate. Okay? It saw the death of its mate. She flew crying over the death place. The bird hunter showed his carelessness on the dead body, on the male bird. The cruel hunter, what did the cruel hunter do here? It treated the male bird as if it is a waste thing. Okay, he thought that dirty linen means as if the dead body of that bird is a waste thing, he thought. Who thought here? The hunter thought like that. The bird's neck was humbled. Humbled means showing a modest. Okay. He picked it up with his hands and jaws and put it in chorus. Chorus means what here? It is a rough bag. Okay, rough washing bag. Understood the two paras? In first para, what happened? The bird was shotted by the hunter. Okay, and the male bird was died and it fell down on the earth. Okay, and in the second para, what happened? The female bird was flying. It was flying around the sky. How it was flying? It was crying. Okay, the female bird flew crying. Okay, and again, the hunter, what he did? He did not see anything, as if it is a waste thing, he thought, and he picked up that dead body of that crane and he put in the waste washing bag. And hope you have understood these two paras. Okay, now let us see the third para. She circled the sky. Okay, what did the female bird do here? She circled round the sky in moment of grace. What is the meaning of grace here? It is the smoothness. Okay, very smoothly what she did? She was circling the sky. Over his disgraceful end, the killers went away and she returned to the death scene with grief that inscribed its intensity in dots and pits like the Morse code of birds' sorrow transmitted to the air. Seer, what the lines are telling you? Okay, the female bird expressed her grief, her feelings. Okay, what is the meaning of grief here? Intense sorrow. It was in the very much sorrow. Who was sorrow here? The female bird. It was very much sad. She circled, okay, the sky gracefully over his disgraceful end. Okay, when the bird has died, she was feeling very bad, crying. She was putting the circle round the sky. When the hunter was gone, okay, the hunter went away with its mate's dead body. The female bird returned to the death scene. It expressed its grief by crying in dots and pits. What is the meaning of dots and pits here? It means द शॉर्ट एंड लॉन्ग क्राइज ऑफ फीमेल बर्ड्स. ओके, इट इज अ कोड वर्ड. ओके, डॉट्स एंड शॉर्ट डॉट्स एंड पिट्स मीन्स इट इज द क्राइंग ऑफ द फीमेल बर्ड्स. द मॉरिस कोड, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मॉरिस कोड हियर, is a symbolic language. It is a symbolic language. It is the combination of long and short sounds. It is a way of communication in birds. Okay, it is the code. Morse code means it is the symbolic language where the birds will communicate. Okay, the Morse code of the bird's sorrow was transmitted in the air. The crying of the female bird, okay, was full round in the air, it was transmitted. Understood the third para? Okay, now next, fourth para, we'll see. With her beak, she kissed a few feathers, picked the ones that wind had not taken away, and sat to hatch the blood-stained feathers into a toddling cheek. Okay, see, after the hunter taking that male bird with them, what did the female bird do again? The female bird was very sad by the unfortunate death of its mate. Okay, it showed its agony pain by kissing the feathers with blood stain. What is the meaning of stain here? Means pore. Okay, the blood, the feathers what were falling down there, they were fully put as if they are dipped in the blood. It was looking like that. Okay, that the wind had not taken away, the cruel hunter has taken away the male bird, this female bird is left with these blood stained. Okay, stained means I told you, no, it as if it is poured. Okay, the colored, the feathers were fully with the red, with the blood color. Okay, the bird desperately wants the male bird back in its life. Suppose if in anybody will die, means we will feel that they have to come back. Yes or no? Like that only. Even this bird also was thinking, my mate should come back to me. It was thinking. She sat on the feathers. Okay, again she sat on those blood stained feathers, and she thought that she was going to hatch on that only, the small cheeks. Okay, now in your house, if hen is there, means you have might seen that the eggs, if they will keep, okay, they will sit on that and they will warm it. Okay, and it will, those eggs will change into the cheeks. Okay, you have seen that. That is called hatching. Okay, and even this Saurus crane also wanted to hatch on the that male bird's feathers, what they were falling there, no? It was thinking that I will sit on them and I will hatch my cheeks. It was thinking there. Okay, next. A wave of the seas she had never seen came to her from far away and cried her to him, carried her to him. She went away beyond human words, beyond the legends and fables of human love. See the last para, so beautifully the writer has written here. In the end, what did the female bird do? It saw a huge wave as if it had not seen before. Okay, the female bird had not seen that before any time. Okay, saw in her life, and it took her with it to her mate. The female bird was also died when the wave very fast it came, and it took the female bird with it, and the female bird also died there. Okay, both the birds went beyond the humus world. What is the meaning of humus here? The strength. Okay, where looking, the strength for where looking. Okay, sorry, the strength for what you are looking for. Okay, what was the ambition of this bird? Even it wanted to go with its mate, yes or no? That only happened, right? Yes, the wave came there and it took the female bird also, and even it died. Okay, the love and affection of the female bird was not less than humans. Yes or no? The last line is telling like that. Yes? And sorry. The love and affection of the female birds was not less than human. Okay? It was beyond the legends and fables of human love. You have seen, no? More than human love, the bird, the female bird showed its love to its mate. Okay? The huge wave, it means, here it is mentioned that the huge wave means it is not real. Okay? It was thinking of that. Okay? Wave, it's the wave of sadness that took her away. The female bird was so much sad, it was very much sad. Okay? So the wave, the thinking of the poet, the wave came and it took the bird. Okay? Hope you have understood this poem. It is a very beautiful poem. Okay? Now, you write this poem in your fair book and you write down this glossary. I will give you the question answers in my next class. Thank you.